name is Dr. Ali. I'm actually a herbalist, a homeopathic practitioner, aromatherapist. So I don't practice allopathy or English medicines. Although I've studied about that as well because I've practiced in pharmaceuticals for about 10, 15 years. But now I'm more into holistic remedies. So I'm a practitioner in Birmingham. I've had my clinic in Edinburgh on about once a week. And we do alternative or complementary treatments. And thank you, Sunil, for inviting me today here.
Thank you for coming.
I think you know more about water than I do because that's your field, but I'll be just basically talking about a few things about the importance of water. And it's all about learning from each other. We can share some knowledge and experience. But what I thought about water, I just put it in some slides for you today. So what is water? It's a symbol of purification, protection, and healing. And it is something which is the base of every, human being for living, I would say. It's not about human beings, but everything, If you study historically, the base of everything is water. So it's a symbol of life. We can't imagine life without water. I mean, there are three things, actually. Clay, air, and water. But water, I think, is one of the most important among these three, which is the base of life, and it composes everything, whatever we see around here. So you know, water being vital, even if you look around different cultures, traditions, or religions as well, we all from different backgrounds. But if you think about our culture, our traditions, our religious practices, whether it's baptism or practicing in Islam or Hinduism, you will find the symbolic presence of water everywhere. So nobody can neglect its importance. So we all know that what kind of rituals we use to make the importance of life in life as well. So you can find it in many historical scriptures, the importance of water, different descriptions about that as well. And I'm here if you want to share some information with me as well, good or bad experience about water as well. So water is the main component and the most important prerequisite for our body. So about 70% of our body is composed of water. And I've seen some nice posters around here as well, which tells you about how much is in your brain, how much is in your kidneys, and different parts of the body rest there as well. So I mean, you've got some more information in this place as well. And I've got some slides to show here as well that 70% of our body's components, they're made of water. It is required for the essential functioning of various organs of all living beings, whether it's plants, kingdom, minerals, or even human beings. We all need water to survive. Anything of nature, even minerals, stones, they all need water as well. So water shortage reduces the moisture content in the body. So if you're low in water, it will determine how moisture you've got in your body, how dry is your body as well. So it will also tell you that do you need to hydrate yourself, or you're okay, you're healthy with that as well, because it deals with different organs of the body as well. So abnormal low levels indicate moisture in the body is too low and the person has a sense of thirst and feeling fatigue as well. So I think in your own product as well, you discuss about all these things, that when you're low in water, the moisture level is low and you start feeling fatigued, tired, lethargic, and obviously you feel thirsty as well. The long-term water shortage usually makes the skin dry and also start showing aging as well. And I think, if I'm not wrong, you can find similar kind of figures on your, posters there as well. That our brain consists of about 75% of water, yep. Blood about 83, heart 79, bones 22, muscles 75, liver and kidneys 86 and 83 collectively. Yeah. I think that's the same figure there as well.
Yeah,
so it's a very, very important component of our body and systems as well. So the amount of water we consume every day plays a very important role in maintaining our healthy body. Okay, so if you don't consume water, if you fast, if you don't take water, you'll see that how much problem you can, come under and you have a lot of consequences of that as well. So adequate and regular water consumption has numerous health benefits as it contains no calories, fats, carbohydrates, or sugar. It's neutral. We can compare between different waters as well, mineral water, spring water, chemical water. So their components, compositions may be different, but at the end of the day, it's free from any fats, carbohydrates, additional sugars, or any extra calories as well. So it's very much beneficial in a component or something we need it regularly to keep up the forming as well. So what are some of the common benefits of water? It's important for many chemical reactions in our bodies. So when you drink water, it's involved with many molecular and functional changes in the body as well. So it's mixed up with different kind of enzymes, different kind of secretions in the body, and they have different, you know, organic and inorganic roles in our systems as well. And most molecules are suspended in water, and in this way they come in contact with other, you know, molecules and chemicals as well. So it's a kind of, you know, carrier in the body as well. So it can take one item, one molecule from one part of the body to another part of the body. So it goes as a transportation, you know, vehicle in the body as well. So water keeps the body well hydrated, which is an essential, you know, thing for our body. Almost every cell in the body needs water to function properly. So we need water everywhere. And how it reaches through our fluid circulation, lymphatic nodes, through our blood. So there is a drainage system in the body, and that transports our body to different organs, different tissues, and ultimately to our cells as well. And they can work properly. It also stabilizes the body's temperature as well. It absorbs and releases heat as well. So it's got multiple functions, and you know about them as well. It works as a lubricating agent as well, a major component of mucus and other lubricating fluids that is very necessary in the abdominal cavity, where various organs touch and slide over each other as well. So it does a lubricating agent in the body as well. So if there is no water, there will be a lot of friction. There will be more damage. So it keeps, you know, organs, because especially if you look around here, especially, you know, when people have, you know, extra fats and low water intake, they get, you know, these as well, they get extra weight as well. And also then it causes more pressure on other organs as well. So they get dyspnea, shortness of breath, some cardiac problems as well. So it's very important because this keeps spaces and moving around different organs, and they function easily as well. So they've got space to breathe out as well. It can also help, you know, treating headaches and migraines as well. So sometimes, you know, when you're low in water, especially when you've got some digestive issues as well, so it can cause migraines and headaches as well. So simply some good quality water can relieve these problems as well. So you don't need to take, you know, analgesics or painkillers all the time. Even sometimes these basic, you know, good quality water can improve your symptoms as well. Have you noticed this? I mean,
yeah.
That's some migraines. Just
mention.
So you can, these are all complementary or alternative treatments. You don't need, you know, medicines all the time. No burden on your system, no burden on your liver. Simple water, or maybe, you know, in aromatherapy, essential oils can also play a similar kind of role as well.
I'm sure that must be the majority of headaches, just dehydration.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yes.
You know, when the weather is too hot, when you excess the sweat out as well, so you lose water, and then you start feeling fatigue, lethargic feeling as well, feeling cold as well, and headaches with that as well.
Yes.
So when you uptake that drop of water, you get your fluid back, and you feel better. But what people do, they normally go for, you know, these painkillers, and they can cause more problem to the system as well. And most, you know, they become addicted actually. And it's a psychological thing, you know. So even teas, coffees, you know, that is only a psychological benefit.
Yes, tricking the brain.
Relief in that.
Yeah, you take tablets and essentially toxin stuff, then you're not flushing it out with water. You just further toxin.
You're just tricking the brain anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Even they call, you know, paracetamol one of the safest, you know, painkiller analgesic, which is called cold tar analgesic. But again, if you use it excessively, it can cause problems as well. So the max you can use is about 4,000 milligram a day, about 8 tablets. But I've seen some people, they take paracetamol, you know, every hour, every 2 hours. But the maximum recommended dose RDA for paracetamol is about not more than 4,000 milligrams, which is about 8 tablets, because it's about 500 milligram each.
What, other than water, obviously, what, in a holistic medicine, what would you...
Okay, holistic medicines, you can take chamomile, valerian. These are, you know, herbs.
Valerian root.
Valerian root.
Yeah.
So you can make its infusion again in some water and just take that, and that can also, because that's a natural, it's called unwinds. They relieve your nervous tensions. So valerian root, chamomile, passiflora, which is called passion flower. So these are all natural painkillers you can use.
I took valerian root to help with sleep, because I don't know how we're trying to sleep.
It's sleep inducing as well. The thing is, they're not sedatives.
No.
They improve your sleep patterns.
Yeah.
So if you want to sleep, have a good sleep pattern, you can take it regularly. It's not something before you sleep, an hour or two before that. Also, we use these essential oils in, you know, some aromatherapy blends as well. So simply massage them on your temples, behind your ears, and you feel, you know, sleepy with that as well. Because through your nose, there are olfactory nerves. So those are senses, you know, take to your brain, and you also feel better and sleep as well. So these are some natural things as well.
And where do you buy these? Decent quality ones.
Well,
that's not
probably not.
I mean, Holland and Venice is one of the, you know, very reputed places, yeah, but there are many online shops like Indigo Herbs.
But how do you know who's good and who's not?
The thing is, we look at their certifications as well. Also, they're recognized, their reviews from their clients as well. Also, sometimes they write the sources as well, because they could be organic, inorganic as well. They could also be, you know, diluted, undiluted as well, because they come in different forms as well. Also, you know, most products you get from European countries, like from France, Germany, and Jersey. So they've got their own, you know, certification certificates available on that as well. Especially for homeopathic medicines, you know, we buy from them. So they come in different dilutions, in different powers, you can send that sense.
For example, I mean, I've had chamomile tea.
Yes.
But it's from Tesco. I mean, is it just rubbish, or is it?
So it depends that. What is their source? Because sometimes they write the source as well.
I wouldn't know.
There are different countries, their clay could be different, the soil could be different as well. Also, it could be organic and inorganic as well. But if you spend some extra money, probably you can get some better quality as well. So Tesco, I mean, these local supermarkets, yes, they've got some, you can say, moderate quality, but not something
not the best.
But if you look for something good, I recommend, you know, Indigo Herbs. There's an online, you know,
Indigo
Herbs, and you can buy anything from them. And they also write the sources and everything.
I think once you find the description of the you know, the place that they actually sell that, they sell quite a lot. It's not just like one thing that they sell.
Also, there are, you know, some places they grow themselves and then they, you know, seem to produce and sell as well.
Mm-hmm.
So they tell you the sources as well.
Just find a good company.
You know, same with waters as well. So you buy plain spring water from Tesco, but also from Sainsbury as well. So the sources might be different. So you have to look at the labels, you know, very carefully.
No.
What the sources are. Well. I mean, if you want that certificate, you can just give me an example.
Yeah.
So it all depends as well. Also, it's very important for, you know, your dryness inside the body as well.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're low in water, it can cause skin problems, dryness, eczema is very, you know, common here, psoriasis.
So it's not just from outside, also from inside of the body.
Actually, the skin problem arises from inside.
Okay.
So if your gut flora, if your lungs are compromised, you will have more skin problems. So if your gut, you know, the gastrointestinal tract is dry, you'll get more constipation. Because the stools will get dry, difficult to expel as well. So you need water for that as well. I mean, there could be other reasons, like peristalsis function. Sometimes your muscles function and it's very slow, and you get sluggish movement inside your bowels as well. But one of the factors could also be low levels of water. So water is more important. And your good health starts from your good, you know, digestive system. If your digestive system, your liver system, they're stronger, they're better, you feel healthy most of the time. Also, it helps weight loss as well. Because the more water you drink, the more toxins it can remove from your body as well. And if you add water with some kind of fiber, it will stick to any unwanted waste material from the body, and you'll get more, you know, sluggish moving improvement in that as well. So it can also help you weight loss.
How much toxin does an average, difficult, by a 50-year-old?
It depends on the
environment. Simon.
The thing is, we can't determine it like this after your age. You know, some people who's living in the countryside, she's 80.
Depends.
But somebody
like
living in the city,
depends how much McDonald's.
It depends that what is your environment like, what is your food intake like, what are you in contact with. Some people, you know, they've got artificial jewelry. Sometimes you don't get
toxins
from that as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it all depends.
Yeah.
What is your
environment? We're all different.
If you're living in a city in industrial area, so even in the environment, you absorb a lot of toxins as well. Through your skin, through your inhalation as well. So it's not about your age.
It's a lot from lager.
Yeah.
In fact.
I don't think it's a matter of, you know, age. It's about your living style.
Yeah.
So if you change your lifestyle, if you frequently detox your body as well. Now, detoxification is not only about your liver, it's about your kidneys, it's about your stomach, it's about most of your functions. If you constantly detox yourself every 3 months, 6 months, you can get rid of these toxins. And there are many ways of doing this. You can go for a detox diet, you can go for an lymphatic drainage massage, you can do reflexology. There are so many options to that. But it depends on what you want to achieve from there. One of the best herbs I recommend for your digestive health is senna. Senna leaves. And that's one of the best, you know, to detox your digestive system.
You eat them?
Yes, just make infusion. They are available in tea bags. Just
a
tea bag. And
you spell that?
S-E-N-N-A. And you know, during this COVID, you know, break,
good for
it was short. It was short in the market.
Wow.
You couldn't buy that. It was short in Birmingham. Yes, because some herbalists, they recommended that.
Right.
Because it improves your immunity. Because you will get rid of your toxins, so it can boost up your immunity as well. So even I was struggling to buy, and I imported some from Turkey. You know the senna, it was short here.
But it's all right now.
It's all right now.
It won't be in a month again.
We bought it all.
So if you ever have no constipation or sluggish bowel movement, just take a few infusions, or you can buy loose, senna leaves, simply boil and just take a couple of cups and you should go right.
But will it make you? Will it give you? If you're not bad, will it give you diarrhea?
Yes.
It may.
Right. Maybe so if you're
all right. Regular emotions, then you shouldn't go for that. Also, you shouldn't consume, even herbs are not safer, remember. Some people say that all herbs are safe, it's not true. You shouldn't use senna for more than 7 days.
Yeah.
If you're using senna, don't use it more than 7 days, otherwise you'll be addicted to that as well. And
okay.
It can cause dehydration.
Okay,
so there should be moderation in that. So even if you're using herbs, you should know pros and cons of those as well. So it can help you weight loss, water. And you can add, again, any herb in water and take that. Because it's difficult to take it without that. Because it flushes out toxins, it's an excellent detoxifier, and helps flush out toxins and get rid of any waste, primarily through sweat and urine, and also through stools as well. So it's a good carrier. It can remove toxins through different excretory systems in the body. Also, if you don't sweat a lot, so sometimes your glands are, they're blocked as well, or sometimes they're low in water intake as well. So you should improve that, so you'll sweat as well. Because if your glands are blocked, they're not good sign.
Also, not sweating is also not good.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
You
should sweat. Because if you're not sweating, it means the more accumulation of toxins in the system,
yes.
Then it can cause more damage in long term as well. So you need to try to either do some exercise, some sauna, water, or steam, or
Or
then there are some herbs, there are some homeopathic remedies which can help reduce more sweating as well. Guys, how much and how to? I mean, you know better about this, but I'll give you my, some suggestion that how much water we should take every day and how to take this as well. Because even taking water, how to take it, how to drink is another, very important thing as well.
Yes.
So what my opinion is, it may be different from yours, we learn about it. We should, at least 8 to 10 small glasses of water must be consumed at hourly intervals for an efficient, healthy living. So we should drink water throughout the day in intervals, not in one go.
Yes. Yeah.
Very important.
Yeah.
Some people, they just finish 1 liter in one go, it's no good.
Because they take it as a duty.
Yes.
That way.
Okay, so at short intervals, in smaller sips,
yes.
And at least 8 to 10 glasses at least,
yes.
Every day.
Would you
good size.
Would you flush more, if you're down in water, I guess, would you flush more good things for your system rather than, or not?
No, it depends on your kidneys then.
Yeah.
If your kidneys are functioning properly, we've got nephrons, which are just like strainer. If there's a problem, then you lose proteins through there,
yeah.
You can also do some other important
that's
things
right.
as well.
I mean,
so it all depends on your kidneys as well.
You just put pressure on them.
And you can find, if you've got any edemas, swellings, water retention, you'll find some swelling around that as well. So that can also give you some hint that there's something wrong with your kidneys. Also, if your kidneys are not functioning, you will get itchiness, pruritus, because you get more toxins in the body as well. So some indicators are there which can tell you that how healthy you are.
Yeah.
We do some tests as well, but generally you can also find some about yourself as well without doing any tests. So you need to sit down, first of all.
Yes.
You shouldn't walk around and drink water.
Yes.
It's no good. We must sit down. Okay,
yes.
That's another thing. Because while you're telling people about drinking water, tell them to sit as well. And drink in three, breathing pauses as well. Don't just in one gulp, in three smaller pauses. And that will give you some more benefits as well. Scientifically, it's also numerically very good as well. According to your daily requirement, at least about 1.5 to 2 liters a day in intervals. So that is, a good range, about 2 liters a day.
Minimum.
But if you want to lose weight, what I recommend to my clients or my patients who want to lose weight and they simply want to do through water, 5 liters every day.
Yes.
So if you consume 5 liters a day, lukewarm water, maybe Kangen water, they will have a very good use of it. They wouldn't need any other medication.
Yeah.
So simply 5 liters a day for 3 months, it can cut down a lot of body strawberry as well.
What's but 3 breathing pauses? What's an example? What do you mean?
Well, basically, you don't double it.
Yeah.
Give me that. sometimes you're really thirsty and you're dry and you want to finish water in one, gap, it's not right. So drink it in 3 small intervals. I think it's going to get some water.
Oh, we haven't even thought of it now.
Also, if you drink water while you're standing and walking, it can affect your joints.
Yeah.
Okay? And that's one of the, you can say,
why
is reason?
About stomach as well.
Stomach?
It, yeah. It
that's it. Why you need to sit down.
Treat it like food.
Three in small. One. Then second one. And maybe in the third one, if you need more water, you can take more.
Is it to like notify the system that you
kind of warn it that you kind of
you warn
it
that something's coming? And
yeah.
Okay.
That makes sense. But because even like showers and stuff like that, if it's in the wrong temperature, you can shock your body.
So normally, even if you go shower, take some water and sprinkle on your body first. So make the temperature, you know, ready for your body as well. And then you can have the shower as well. So don't jump in water and river straight away.
Yeah.
Try to simply, you know, get
you
it.
So there's something to that, some people in there throwing it all on
and
the body.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're, you know, internal areas are really dry, it's no good to just drink freezing water.
No,
it can cause a lot of damage. So even if you're drinking any water, it should be lukewarm. It should be lukewarm. It shouldn't be too cold as well. So sit down, either on a chair or the floor, and just drink in three smaller, you know, grapes as well. So small doses can keep your kidneys clean as well. Drinking smaller doses, smaller amounts, that will help clean your kidneys as well. And it promotes kidney function and reduces renal stones as well. It can help dissolve renal stones as well. I mean, you've got gallbladder stones sometimes you've got kidney stones as well. So water can help with the kidney stones. It can dissolve them. Because it dilutes the salts and minerals in the urine that can cause kidneys or, you know. Water relieves fatigue and improves your mood as well. If you're really angry, if you're really up, you know, down, you can simply drink water and it will uplift your mood as well. So it's a natural, you can say, nerve wine as well. It improves your nervous system. You feel better after taking water. Also, you can see, if you don't give this to your plant, how can you give this to your children? It's no good.
Yes.
I found this picture online, by the way. It's a very good. We buy these farro cakes for ourselves, which is not good.
Yeah.
Nature doesn't need these things. Nature needs something pure,
mm-hmm.
purified, and that can help with that as well.
I was thinking about that yesterday. That one of the best photos I've seen is when they're putting or either potato or plants in Kangen water. That's one that's growing the most out of all the
water. Of course.
Nature knows
they
best,
know
right?
They
nature knows best.
Nature knows.
Nature knows.
There's no doubt about it. We are still learning about nature. It will take, I don't know how many years, but we are learning about these things. And even, you know, the scientific, you know, coaches and doctors, they're also coming to nature now. Many people. You know,
they should.
They are coming now. Because history repeats itself as well. Things they were using in the past, now they're starting using here. So bring, again, some general kind of information and help for you as well. So if you drink 2 glasses of water in the morning, it can help improve your internal organs as well. So from wake up, if you drink a glass or two, it can help improve your system and they start functioning as well. And drinking 1 glass of water before a meal will help in digestion. So try not to drink water during meals. You shouldn't drink water at least half an hour, minimum 30 minutes before or after a meal. You should drink it before that, and that will help improve digestion as well. And if you add some, you know, some fiber in that, that will cut down your food intake, and that can also help you lose weight as well. You know, Silent Husk, have you heard of Silent Husk?
Yeah.
There are many something similar, right? So you can add some in water, take it, because it will expand in your stomach. So the food intake will become lower in that side. So you can also lose weight in that sense as well. And drinking 1 glass of water before taking a shower helps prevent high blood pressure. So you should also take some water before taking a shower. Drinking a glass of water before bed helps prevent strokes and heart attacks. So these are some of the studies, some researches, some observations, and these things can also help. So you can spit water throughout the day for your daily activities, and they can prevent you from many, you know, health conditions as well.
Yeah.
Some general health for you. And the last slide is about some of the top hydrating foods. So some people, you know, they don't like water because of the taste or something similar. So they can make infused waters, or they can take these foods directly as well. What I normally do, I, you know, put any leftover, you know, vegetables or fruit in my water and leave it overnight and use that water all day next day. So that gives me some energy, some taste, some flavor, and the benefits of these fruits and vegetables as well. So you can make infusions for infused waters as well. So you can add something in that as well. So cucumbers, watermelons, pineapples, lettuce, tomatoes, celery, pears, grapefruit, blueberries, and melons. These are some of the top, you know, fruits or vegetables you can find in high water or, you know, high virginity. That's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
anything I'm here to discuss, share any questions you may have, so probably we can learn from each other. I'm not here to give you any lecture or anything to impose on you, but anything about nature, about herbs, homeopathy, aromatherapy, I'm happy to have any questions about any of your health conditions. Alternative treatments, you know,